Hi guys, Jai Shri Mahakal. As we have previously announced that we will be starting the services question series that will be fully solved. So here it is. So before starting, I will tell you why engineering services questions are so much important. Even if you are preparing for GATE or SSC-JE or even BARC and ISRO. So I will tell you the importance of engineering services questions and what we will be doing in this video series. So let's see in the second slide why engineering services questions, solving engineering services questions are so much important. So these are the four points which will make them so much important. If you are preparing for GATE, then you should and you must solve engineering services questions, because for that one mark question, MCQ questions, they directly come from engineering services. So uske liye sabse important cheez hai GATE ke jo one mark question ko solve karna, jo 25 questions will be asked in GATE, that one mark जो फैक्ट बेस्ड क्वेश्चन होंगे, डायरेक्टली डायरेक्ट क्वेश्चन होंगे, वन वर्ड आंसर क्वेश्चन होंगे, वो इंजीनियरिंग सर्विसेज के क्वेश्चन से डायरेक्टली उठा के दीजिए। इफ यू डोंट बिलीव, आप 2016 का पेपर देख लीजिए गेट का, दैट हार्डनेबिलिटी क्वेश्चन, ज्योमेट्री टेस्ट क्वेश्चन, डिड यू रिमेंबर, दैट वाज डायरेक्टली केम फ्रॉम इंजीनियरिंग सर्विसेज क्वेश्चंस इन गेट। सो देयर आर हंड्रेड्स ऑफ एग्जांपल इन विच यू कैन सी दैट इंजीनियरिंग सर्विसेज क्वेश्चंस आर डायरेक्टली कमिंग गेट, एसएससी, जेईई एंड डिफरेंट एग्जामिनेशंस। सो सेकंड पॉइंट इज, इफ यू आर preparing for SSC-JE, then you must solve engineering services questions, because since last 2-3 years you have seen that the question level of SSC-JE is rising so much. 2017-18 ka paper dekh lijiye, kaafi questions, kaafi acche level ke questions bana rahe hain aur directly SSC engineering services se bhi aa rahe hain, jo वैसे तो हमेशा ही आते थे engineering services से, लेकिन अब उनका level भी बढ़ गया because of their options also. You have seen in 2018 question papers, if you see, you can see they are highly conceptual and they are difficult also because of their options also. So if you are preparing for SSC-JE, then you should solve engineering services questions, that last 29 years questions, each and every question. क्योंकि engineering services में 30 साल में इतने क्वेश्चन पूछे जा चुके हैं कि कोई कंसेप्ट ही नहीं बचा, ना कोई फैक्ट बेस्ड क्वेश्चन ऐसे ज्यादा बचे हैं उसके बाद जो किसी एग्जाम में अलग से पूछा जा सके, बहुत रेयर चांस। थर्ड एंड आई थिंक इज वन ऑफ द मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट पॉइंट इज, highly conceptual questions are asked in engineering service pre-examinations. Questions which are framed as assertion reasoning and all, as well as one word answer questions, they are highly conceptual. That will help you very much in the interview preparation also. Believe me guys. If you are preparing for interview like BARC, ISRO or any other PSU, you should solve engineering services questions, or you should go through the engineering services questions. And if you are not getting the answer, you can refer theory related to that, so that you will cover each and every topic that can be asked in the interview. And fourth and the most important point for engineering services aspirants, if you are preparing for engineering services only, तब तो आपको एक भी क्वेश्चन छोड़ना नहीं है इंजीनियरिंग सर्विसेज का। क्यों? क्योंकि 30 से 35% क्वेश्चन वैसे के वैसे रिपीट हो रहा है। आप कोई भी पेपर उठा के देख लीजिए, क्योंकि आप क्वेश्चन बचे ही नहीं है 30 साल में, क्वेश्चन का सेचुरेशन आ चुका है। तो 30% क्वेश्चन तो आपको रिपीट मिल ही जाएंगे, वो 30% क्वेश्चन मतलब बहुत होता है, 105-106 नंबर हो गया। मतलब अगर प्रीवियस ईयर क्वेश्चन को ठीक से ही कर लेते हैं, उससे रिलेटेड थ्योरी को एब्जॉर्ब कर लेते हैं बहुत ही अच्छे, उसको प्री निकालना प्रॉब्लम नहीं है। तो न्यूमेरिकल तो आप देखेंगे कि वैसे के वैसे रिपीट होते हैं, सिर्फ डेटा चेंज हो जाता है। सबसे पहला चैप्टर हम स्टार्ट करेंगे फ्लूइड मैकेनिक्स, क्योंकि ये बहुत ही ज़्यादा इंपॉर्टेंट है। आप ये देख रहे हैं 60-65% मार्क्स वेटेज है इसका इंजीनियरिंग सर्विसेज में, और हर एग्जाम में फ्लूइड मैकेनिक्स बहुत ही ज़्यादा इंपॉर्टेंट होता है। फ्लूइड मैकेनिक्स और फ्लूइड मशीनरी मिला के 65 मार्क्स तो सिर्फ आपको इसी से मिल रहा है, मतलब इसमें 70% मार्क्स तो ईजिली आप रहते हैं, 70% क्वेश्चन ईजी रहता है, और 20-25% और 30% क्वेश्चन थोड़ा डिफिकल्ट है। इसमें करीब 20 चैप्टर्स हम चैप्टर वाइज डिस्कस करेंगे, और उसकी मैं अलग अलग वीडियोज बनाऊंगा, तो आपको प्रॉब्लम नहीं आएगी और मैं उसे प्लेलिस्ट में डाल दूंगा। तो जो इम्पोर्टेंट वेटेज वाले सब्जेक्ट्स हैं हम पहले कवर करेंगे, जैसे फ्लूइड मैकेनिक्स, पावर प्लांट, हीट ट्रांसफर एंड थर्मो। ठीक है, तो चलिए देश रिकॉग्नाइज करते हैं फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन से, दैट इज मैच द फॉलोइंग क्वेश्चन, मैच द लिस्ट ऑफ द प्रॉपर्टीज विद देयर डेफिनेशंस। ओके, नाउ सबसे पहले फर्स्ट यू नीड टू नोट दैट जब भी मैच द फॉलोइंग के क्वेश्चंस है, यू नीड टू राइट ए बी सी एंड डी, मेक अ टेबल ऑफ इट। इस तरीके से आप लिख लीजिए, आपको टेबल बनाने की जरूरत नहीं है, बस आप उसे लिख लीजिए ए बी सी डी एंड देन एंड फिल द स्पेस 1 2 4 3 और व्हाटएवर इट इज. सो व्हाट इज द पॉइंट इन आइडियल फ्लूइड? एज वी नो आइडियल फ्लूइड हैज जीरो विस्कोसिटी. ओके, नाउ वी नीड टू मैच विद दिस फ्लूइड. फ्लूइड इज एट जीरो विस्कोसिटी. ओके, सो इट इज टू फॉर ए इट इज टू. Now, Newtonian fluid. Newtonian fluid, what is the property? Its viscosity is constant with the rate of deformation. It does not change. So, its shear stress increases linearly with rate of deformation. We know that two things. Now, make the following. Viscosity does not vary with the first option is mentioned. Okay. So, AB21. Now, for C, AB21 means 1 or 2 are neglected and CAD might be the answer. Now the third option, mu by rho, that is kinematic viscosity, we all know that. So kinematic viscosity 5 1 2 5, now D will be the answer. Now you don't need to solve the D because we have already matched the right option. Save time and move forward. Mercury in a glass, viscosity. Mercury in a glass, that is capillary depression. Mercury in a glass, when it is in a glass, it will not rise, it will, because of it is a non-wetting fluid, so it will fall, and water will rise, it is a wetting fluid. Now second question, again the match the column A, B, C, D, you have to write capillarity. Capillarity is because of the surface tension, we know that. Vapor pressure is because of cavitation causes, when the local pressure is less than the vapor pressure, then the cavitation causes. And what are the places, like suppose this is a pump, it is a suction, we have at the suction cavitation can cause, for a turbine outlet here also cavitation can cause, draft tube inlet and submarines. This is a submarine propeller, it is moving like this. So whenever propeller rotates with high velocity, this region pressure decreases and the cavitation occurs. So submarine propellers are designed nowadays with low RPM and big sizes. So these are the places where cavitation can cause. So point D is matched with 1. Viscosity. Viscosity causes shear force, that is 3. Specific gravity, because of density of water. You can easily match this. So 4, 1, 3, 2. They can move forward without wasting time. Now it is assertion reasoning questions. These are kind of questions which check the basic concepts of a student. You should read your notes thoroughly. बिल्कुल thoroughly आपको notes पढ़ना है ताकि आपको पता है क्या लिखा है. Assertion क्या है? In a fluid, the rate of deformation is more important than solid deformation itself. So suppose in a solid, if shear force is applied, it will deform like this. So it will shear like this, but after some time it will stop at this point. So the deformation is, shear deformation is absolute, it will not change in case of solids. But in case of liquids, if shear force is applied, it will continue to deform. So there is no absolute deformation. So how to calculate this deformation? By rate of deformation. This, so rate of deformation is for liquid, so this is correct. First assertion is correct. Now, जब भी assertion region का question आए, आपको क्या करना है? You need to read assertion, then put because in between, and then you have to read the reason. जब आप इसे collectively पढ़ेंगे, when you collectively read this both statements by using because in between, you will get to know both the total whole statement is relevant or not. तो जब आप स्टेटमेंट पढ़ोगे तो आपको बिल्कुल समझ में आ जाएगा, है ना. तो आपको assumption पढ़ना है, फिर because लगाना है, फिर reason पढ़ना. तो reason क्या है? A fluid is continuous to deform so as long as the external forces are applied, as I have explained here. So it is correct. तो आप पढ़िए इसे. In a fluid, the rate of deformation is far more important than the deformation itself because a fluid continues to deform so as long as the external forces are applied. Correct. It is correct. Suppose अगर ऐसा होता, fluid in a fluid, a rate of deformation is far more important than the total deformation because earth is round. Is it relevant? No. So you need to solve assertion and reason like this. Now, assertion reason में एक चीज और ध्यान रखना है, जो options दिए हुए हैं कभी कभी change कर देते हैं. होता है ऐसा कभी कभी. JWM में ऐसा हुआ था. Junior Works Manager की जो Ministry of Defence की जो exam हुई थी उसमें ऐसा हुआ था, तो उसको ध्यान से पढ़िए कभी कभी. भले ही change ना हो एक बार जरूर देख लीजिए. Again, question 4. Which one of the following is the bulk modulus of the fluid? First, we will discuss compressibility. Compressibility formula is what? 1 by V, del V by del P, or 1 by rho by del P. So, bulk modulus is what? 1 upon compressibility. It is reciprocal of compressibility. So, it can be written as just reciprocal of it. Rho del P by del rho. So, option A will be the right answer. Neglected. Okay, question 5. Now don't get in hurry in solving this kind of question. It's wrong. It's easy. Surface tension is asked. Dimension of surface tension are, first we need to write your SI unit of surface tension. That is Newton per meter. So this is wrong. Newton per meter square likha hai. Watt per meter likha hai. That can also be wrong because we cannot convert D into this Newton per meter. Now check this. Newton. Now joules is given. So joules kya hota hai? Energy unit hoti hai. So it can also be equal to work done, force into displacement. That is Newton meter. So joules per meter square kya hoga? Newton meter upon meter square. 1 meter meter gets cancelled, that Newton per meter. So C will be the right option. All this get cancelled. Now B ko dekhiye, Newton meter per meter हो रहा है, तो न्यूटन हो रहा है, तो कैंसर है, तो इसी इज द करेक्ट आंसर. नाउ क्वेश्चन नंबर 6, इट इज अ गुड क्वेश्चन. व्हिच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग फोर्स एक्ट्स ऑन अ फ्लूइड एट रेस्ट. वी नो दैट फ्लूइड एट रेस्ट विस्कस फोर्सेस आर जीरो, देयर इज नो विस्कस फोर्स, सो यू हैव टू नेग्लेक्ट इट इन द फर्स्ट साइड. अब भी चौथा अगर गलत है, देन ए इज रॉन्ग, सी इज रॉन्ग, डी इज रॉन्ग, सो ओनली डी विल बी द आंसर. Viscous forces cannot act on a fluid, on a particle which is at rest. If it is moving, only viscous forces are applied. So fluid at rest, there is no viscous force. Okay, like this you have to solve. Do not show your knowledge, just tick and move forward. Now question number 7, surface tension is due to, it is cohesion. Cohesion is what? The force of attraction between the same particle is called cohesion. Suppose this is mercury particle, this is mercury particle, the force of attraction between each same molecules, that is cohesion. Adhesion is what? Adhesive chipakna. Do alag alag component ko chipkane ke liye adhesive use hota. The force of attraction between the two different molecules, suppose mercury and glass, the force of attraction between them is adhesion. Now capillarity is due to, there are some questions in, sometimes it is asked, capillarity is due to, that is due to surface tension, not cohesion. And surface tension is due to cohesion, and capillarity is due to surface tension. Like that you need to remember. Newton's law of viscosity depends upon, first you have to write Newton's law of viscosity. Shear stress is proportional to rate of deformation or shear strain. Shear stress equals to mu del u by del y. So it is a relation between shear stress and rate of deformation. Where it is, without wasting time, just click and move forward. C will be the answer. Shear stress and rate of deformation. Now 9th question, the normal stress is same in all the direction at point. It is a statement of Pascal's law. Okay. The normal stress is same in all the directions at a point in fluid only when the fluid has zero, one fluid layer has no motion relative to the other. It is fluid frictional, it is incorrect. Fluid is frictional, again it is incorrect. Fluid has zero viscosity, not necessary. It is at rest, it is okay, but zero viscosity is not necessary. So fluid, if it is having no motion relative to the adjacent layer, then only Pascal's law is valid. So D will be the answer. Then question, in a surface tension of water air interface is 0.073 Newton per meter, the gauge pressure inside the raindrop is 1 mm diameter. Now first we can see for raindrop gauge pressure is equals to 4 sigma by D. Isko series mein yaad kijiye, bubbles, for bubbles, soap bubbles, that is 8 sigma by D. For air bubbles, it is again 4 sigma by D, only one surface. Why it is double of that raindrop? Because raindrop has only one surface and the soap bubble has one surface inside and one surface outside. So it is double of that. Now, for a liquid jet, it is 2 sigma by D. So you need to remember all this formula in a series, in a sequence. To start gauge pressure ka formula laga dijiye, raindrop ka 4 sigma by D, 4 into 0.073 upon, we have to convert the diameter into meter. So it will be 4 into 73, that is 292. D will be the answer. Now 11th question, assertion reasoning again. If a cube, assertion is, if a cube is placed in liquid with two of its surface parallel to the free surface of the liquid, then the pressure on the two surface which are parallel to the free surface. Suppose this is the free surface of the water and the cube is placed inside it, and this is the top surface and this is the bottom surface. Both are parallel with the surface. Now what it is telling, the pressure on the two surface which are parallel to the surface are same. Highly incorrect. Highly incorrect. How can it be same? It is telling that pressure here, pressure on this surface and this surface are same. No, pressure depends on the height, depth, that is changing. So the pressure here is less and here is more. That is proportional to height. As we know that pressure variation is written as minus rho g dz. Z is what? Depth or height. So assertion is incorrect. So you have, so D will be the answer. A is false and reason is true. Don't write, don't read the reason if it is already incorrect. So you have, you need to proceed to the second next question. Guys, आपसे request है, मैं तो ये बोलने ही भूल गया starting. आप अगर ये वीडियो सीरीज देख रहे हैं तो आप पेन और कॉपी लेके बैठिए, तभी आपको इसका फुल बेनिफिट मिलेगा, अदरवाइज मजा नहीं आएगा. तो प्लीज टेक आउट योर पेन एंड कॉपीज सो दैट वी कैन सॉल्व टुगेदर. ओके, नाउ 12th क्वेश्चन, द शियर स्ट्रेस डेवलप्ड इन द लुब्रिकेटिंग ऑयल ऑफ विस्कोसिटी 0.9 पॉइज फील्ड बिटवीन द टू पैरेलल प्लेट्स 1 सेंटीमीटर अपार्ट एंड मूविंग विद रिलेटिव वेलोसिटी ऑफ 2 मीटर पर सेकंड. So first concentrate on units, that is 9.81 poise. 1 poise equal to 0.1 Pascal second or 0.1 Newton second per meter square या फिर 0.1 kg per meter second. ठीक है, you need to remember this. Now for the two parallel plates, one is moving and one is at rest, the shear force, shear stress is given by mu, that is dynamic viscosity, mu v by h. H is the distance between the two plates and v is the velocity, u is the viscosity of the oil. So shear stress will be mu, that is 0.981 v 2 meter per second h, 0.01. you need to convert it, what will be this term, 98.1 into, that will be 196.2. Okay, check your calculation at least 2 times. Okay, now the 13th question, a capillary tube is inserted in a mercury kept in an open container. Here it is. Assertion is, the mercury level inside the tube shall rise. Highly incorrect, so D will be the answer. As I have already in previous question, I have told that if mercury is placed, it is a non-wetting fluid, so it will go down because the cohesion forces are more than the adhesion forces, that is why it will fall down. So If it is water, then it will write like this. So don't need to read this region because D will be the answer. But question 14, the phenomena of cavitation, the characteristics of fluid involves the vapor pressure. I've told you vapor pressure is less than the local pressure is less than the vapor portion, then the cavitation will occur. 15th, the capillary rise at 20 degrees Celsius in glass tube, a clean glass tube of 1 mm diameter containing water is approximately 1. So we need to find this edge, how much it will rise. So the surface tension in multiplied by the circumference, that will be equal to that force will be equal to the weight of the fluid. So 2 pi r sigma cos theta equals to rho g h. Pi r square h rho g volume into density into gravity, that is equal to total weight. And the value of theta for water is 0 degree and the value of theta for h is 130 degrees. So the value of h will be 2 sigma cos theta, that is 1 here, upon rho g r. What 4 sigma cos theta by rho gt. We can convert this r to diameter. So h equals to 4 sigma cos theta by rho gt. 4 sigma is what? 0.073 upon rho, that is 100, g and 10, and diameter is m meter 0.001. Again multiplied by 1000 to convert it to millimeters. So what do we get? 29.3. That is equal to 30 mm. So, D will be the answer. Now, see, friends, don't get confused with this value. It is lesser than D or what. Because we have taken surface tension as 0.073. It is actually 0.0736. We have taken gravity as 10, but actually it is 9.81 something. Okay. So, you have to take approximate values. If the difference in the answers are very large, here 10 difference, 5 difference, here 20 difference. So you can take approximate value. Okay. Now again, there is the following question. Okay. We have to match this option with this ideal fluid. So type of the fluid and shear stresses. Variation of shear stresses. We know that for ideal fluid, shear stress is 0. Viscosity is 0. That is the reason why shear stress is 0. So we need to match A with 4. Now P, Newtonian fluid. You know that for Newtonian fluid, it is linear, shear stress is linear with rate of deformation. So that will be this. So B1. C, D we don't know, but we don't need to calculate, observe them, because D will be the answer. Because we have matched A and B. And 4 and 1 is present in only one option. So you need to take and move forward within 20 seconds. But for your information, I can discuss the shear stress and rate of deformation of the different fluids. Ideal fluid has zero viscosity, zero shear stress, like this. This is ideal fluid. Newtonian fluid is linear variation. Bingham plastic, it is having some value here. If it is having a real solid for solids, this is the region graph for solid. For dilatant fluid, it is increasing like this, and for thixotropic, it is increasing but with a decreasing slope. For dilatant, it is increasing slope. I have made one short trick also, so I will discuss this thoroughly in my short trick videos. Okay. तो आज हमने 16 क्वेश्चन डिस्कस किए हैं और करीब एटलीस्ट 30 कंसेप्ट डिस्कस किए हैं. बाकी के क्वेश्चंस मैं आज रात में या कल मॉर्निंग में डिस्कस करूंगा और फिर कंटिन्यूअसली मैं वीडियोस अपलोड करता रहूंगा इंजीनियरिंग सर्विसेज क्वेश्चंस. तो प्लीज फ्रेंड्स, आप बताइए आपको वीडियो कैसा लगा, इसमें क्या कमियां थी और क्या क्या चीजें इंप्रूव हो सकती है. और इफ यू हैव एनी डाउट इन एनी काइंड ऑफ क्वेश्चन, यू कैन आस्क इन द कमेंट बॉक्स. और एक लाइक जरूर ठोक दीजिएगा भाई, अगर थोड़ा बहुत ठीक रहा तो सब्सक्राइब के साथ साथ नोटिफिकेशन बेल आइकन प्रेस कर दीजिएगा ताकि आपको नोटिफिकेशन मिले. सिर्फ सब्सक्राइब करने से आपको नोटिफिकेशन नहीं मिलता, नहीं मिला। थैंक यू सो मच। जय श्री महाकाल।